There are a lot of biological assays that we perform on nucleic acids, and as scientists, we have a certain visual shorthand that we use when we describe them. To diagram out an assay, we usually draw something like, for example, this: a single-stranded circular DNA template, and a primer that anneals to it, and then, if you add your DNA polymerase and other required reagents, your primer gets extended. This is a great simplified conceptual representation of this assay, but what would we actually start with in our test tube if we did this assay in a lab? Would we really have one single-stranded DNA circle and one primer? Actually, if we tried to do this assay with one molecule of each of these pieces of DNA, we would be unable to see any result. Even if they managed to find each other in the solution and carry out the reaction, when we performed gel electrophoresis and visualized that gel, we wouldn't be able to see anything because the signal from that one molecule would be too low. When we run DNA on an agarose gel and see a band, that band is the signal from a whole population of DNA molecules of the same length or topological state, which hence migrate to the same location in the gel. If we have just one molecule, there's not enough signal to actually see it. Instead, what we would have in our test tube is actually a large population of molecules. In an average assay, we would actually be adding trillions of copies of the primer and trillions of copies of the template. Statistically speaking, not every single one of these primers will find a template, and even for the primer-template junctions that do form, not every single one will find a DNA polymerase. But there are so many molecules floating around in your test tube that there will still be a lot of cases where you do carry out your desired reaction. And there are enough of these product molecules that when you perform gel electrophoresis and visualization, you'll be able to see your signal. This is also why you will often still see unextended primers that have migrated to the bottom of your gel towards the positive cathode, even after we've given the reaction lots of time to run. You are starting with so many primers that some of them will just remain primers. So, whenever you see an assay diagrammed out like this in simplified terms, remember, each molecule in the diagram represents trillions of molecules just like it, ready to play their part in your assay.